Good afternoon. This is Cool Hand. I want to apologize to people from yesterday. I was not really feeling really well, and my videos really sucked. So I just wanted you to know that I wasn't something I snorted or anything illegal, but I was just feeling like shit. Now, politically correct bullshit is hurting this country badly. I blame Newt Gingrich, the Speaker of the House we had back in the 90s. He was the prick that said to his members, don't talk to Democrats. And then he's the one that started this thing about political elites on both coasts. And he, you know, I went and did a day of finding political elites, and I couldn't find them. But I know where they are, Newt. If you're watching, they're up your ass. That's where they are. Jeez, man. Political elites. They're all, you know, so what? Just the Democrats are political elites? How about the Republicans, man? You guys kiss the ass of every damn rich person. I mean, it's disgusting what you do, man. The oral you guys give. I mean, jeez. But that's for another topic. We got to knock this off right now. You know, this wokeism and all the bullshit going on. Because it doesn't make this country better. It just hurts the country. You know, there's people right now asking, they want to start a civil war over what? Because someone doesn't believe what you're saying to them? I mean, you're going to start a civil war for that? Are you fucking nuts? Give me a break. You know, right now, this is really super easy. We got two parties, the Democrats and the Republicans. We've tried third parties. I've tried to work with being a third party. It just doesn't work. So we got the Democrats and the Republicans. On the Democratic side, there's some good ideas. I mean, I think Joe's trying hard. I mean, he's got stuff passed. I mean, he's gotten some passed that Donald couldn't get his 4 whole years. I mean, he's passed a lot of stuff that's going to help the average American citizen. But does most Americans even know it's happened? No, because most Americans basically have their head up their ass so far that lump in their throat is their head. I mean, it's disgusting. You know, Americans, you don't know how good you have it. And the bad part is, you never go on vacations to where you really need to. Like Central America, say Honduras, or Guatemala, or Venezuela. And see how the real people live. And it'll open your eyes. Mexico. Certain parts of Mexico City, or Tijuana. I promise you, you will kiss the ground when you get back. And you think you have it bad? No, this is nothing. I mean, trust me, I don't like going into the market and seeing these prices. I don't like seeing the pump price. But guess what? Oh, it's not as bad as you think. There are places right now, a gallon of gas is going for $12 a gallon. A gallon of milk is going for $12 a gallon. I mean, serious shit. There are places right now that the inflation rate is in close to 30% in a few countries right this minute. So if you think we're in bad shape, no. And this is all over the world. The whole world is suffering. It's not just us, but it's the whole world. And I wish Americans would start, you know, you got mostly 75% of the Americans have fast internet. And if you don't go out and reach out and look at the rest, how the rest of the world lives, then you're not doing yourself any favors. Someone asked me, well, where do you get your news? I said, well, I do Vice News, BBC, CBC, that's Canadian Broadcasting, and the there's a really good one, NGC something in Japan, really good. Deutsche Welle, there's a lot of really good independent news organizations out there too. And you should be getting alternative news. You shouldn't just rely on one source, because you're not getting what you need as an American. You know, this American first shit is bullshit. We've tried that dozens of times and it doesn't work. Trying to push ourselves into a corner in our part of the world and let everybody else suck on it. You know, this world is really small and we should be leading. America's great, man. We can, you know, we think of things that other people don't. We get things done. And when I heard Trump, I'm going to make America great. Oh, really? Really, Donald? You're going to make America great? America's always been great, Donald. And if you haven't, if you think it's not, then you're an asshole. America's the greatest country there's ever been because we're free. That's why people come here, because we don't tell them we have a state religion and shut everybody else down. We don't. We allow other religions and other cultures to assimilate into being Americans. And if you don't like that, then go to Hungary or go to Russia. But stop trying to fuck this country up. That's all I'm saying. And this politically correct wokeism and all this other stuff got to stop. You know, like my African-American friends, I keep reminding them. I say, you know, there's a lot of really bad things that white Americans have done to our African-American brothers, especially at the turn of the last century. There was some white race rioting throughout the country. Florida, Oklahoma City is the biggest one. You know, up in Chicago, you name it, there was some terrible stuff. After World War I, it was really bad when the black soldiers came back armed. The whites really lost it. And it's really a bad thing. But like the Republicans are trying to do, they're trying to fuck around with our history in schools. Oh, we don't want to teach our kids about the bad things in history. Oh, it'll make them unhappy. Oh, yeah? So who's going to tell them? The fairy godmother? Bad things have happened and we've done it. We tried to basically put genocide on our American Indian brothers and sisters. And anybody that says we haven't, you're full of shit. In my state of California, Governor Stanford got a bill passed, basically said any Californian can kill an Indian without any probable cause. That's basically open season on Indians. That was back during the gold rush. So don't tell me the bullshit I've heard from people's mouths. That's why your job as a citizen of this country is to vote. It's to make sure everybody you know is registered to vote and either gets a mail-in ballot or goes and votes. That is your job, number one. Number two, your second job is weekly. You need to call your representatives, local and in Washington, and you've got to tell them what you think. Because if you don't, then you get a country that's nuts. Like it's becoming. Because Donald Trump basically took the Republican Party over. And the Republican Party is a bunch of wimpy assholes that don't want to throw Donald Trump into the ocean with bricks. Basically, don't want, like Donald Trump really should. He should be the mafia into the ocean with brick galoshes. But they're so afraid that they will piss off Trump supporters and they'll come and kill their families. Well, you know, then you have no balls. You know, like I say, you know, Ted Cruz. Here's a man that is the biggest pussy in the world. He talks tough, but he isn't. Donald Trump embarrassed him in front of the entire world. Said that his dad helped kill JFK. That's what Donald Trump said. What did Ted Cruz do? Did he get up, go over and say, take it back? Did he get up and punch Donald Trump right in the kisser? No, he sat there and took it. I promise you, if Donald Trump would have said that to me in front of that crowd, I would have gone up and said, you take it back, Donald. And if Donald Trump started some other bullshit, I'd say, you take it back now, Donald. I'm giving you 6 seconds. And I will count to six, and then all shit's going to come down on you. And at the moment of six, I would, even though I would hurt my fist, I would punch Donald Trump right in the mouth and take his teeth out. I would do it and say that I just did that for a reason, Donald, because you said my father killed Kennedy. He didn't. You're a lying sack of shit. But Ted Cruz didn't, and Ted Cruz basically became a Donald Trump bitch. Donald Trump has another one of his bitches. How stinky. You know, like when the Republicans had control of the House and the Senate a few years ago, I was amazed. I keep to this day, it just blows my mind what I've seen. This entire panel, 12 Republican men, they had a panel about rape. There wasn't one woman from the Republican Party there. And these guys, back and forth, were talking about how they should redefine rape. And I'm listening to this bunch of garbage. And what goes off in my mind is these motherfuckers are trying to make it to redefine rape as something they can get away with. And I sent each one of them, these people, I called up their people and I said, you know what this guy's doing. He just made a fool of himself. You can't do what he's trying to make rape into something that it isn't. Same thing with abortion. 12 guys go up. There's not a woman on their panel. And they're trying to unjustify Roe versus Wade. It's disgusting. But our problem in this country is people just don't get pissed enough to call up and say, we've had enough of this. Take it back. And the only way you can do that right now is voting. And if we allow the Republicans in, they're going to do the following. They're going to try to basically defund Social Security, Medicare, and the Affordable Care Act. And then they've said they want to impeach Joe Biden, Kamala Harris, and a few other cabinet members for some reason. There's some outstanding thing they've done that deserves impeachment. And that's all they're going to do. They're not going to get gas prices lower, food prices lower. They're not going to make your lives better. So you have to vote them. You can't allow these people in. You have to vote. You have to vote for the Democrats. I'm sorry. You're going to have to hold your mouth and vote for them. This is Cool Hand. I don't normally run this far into 15 minutes, but I did. Thank you. Bye-bye.